My next guest is going to be fighting for some hardware this Saturday at Octagon 56. It is Aaron Abey joining me here on the program. Aaron, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Good to hear. When did you find out about this fight? Obviously, huge opportunity here, fighting for the flyweight title.
I knew, obviously, after the last fight in January, I was going to be fighting for the belt in April. It was just a matter of finding out if Garcia was going to come defend his belt again or if I'd be fighting somebody new. So it was just waiting for everything to get finalized on that front. But as for the date, you know, that was always in my mind since the last UK card in January.
Excellent. Well, that's good. Always nice to have a lot of notice for fights. And for those who don't know your backstory, man, you've had a bigger fight outside the cage than most people do in the cage. Cystic fibrosis, overcame that. You had stage 3 cancer, overcame that. We know fighting's a very mentally tough game. How much has that translated into your fight game with just being able to overcome adversity like you have in your life outside of the cage?
Yeah, massively. I think it plays a big part in who I am as a person and who I am as a fighter. Like I was born with cystic fibrosis, and it's something that I live with still to this day. And having to overcome challenges and the toughness that brought on throughout my life, it's something that I've tried to develop and improve with over time. And then obviously gaining cancer in my late 20s, which brought up a whole load of new challenges and battles. But I always say this, I feel like fighting's so real. Nothing more translates to life like fighting, and nothing more translates to fighting like life. So I feel like they go hand in hand, and I've been able to like learn and use lessons I've learned from both aspects and put them together to either make me a better person or make me a better fighter.
And you know, I know your fight career is not gone ideal. I mean, you've had some setbacks, but you've overcome it. I'm sure, again, just going through all those things has sort of helped push you through where a lot of fighters might have said, you know what, you know, this isn't working out, but here you are fighting for a title.
Yeah, you know, it's almost like becoming a thing now that there is no fairy tale ending with Aaron Abey. And, you know, this is my chance to have that story ending again on the weekend. But you know, I love what I do, and I've been fortunate to do it for as long as I have and progress with it, and I'm just love each day. So I take life as it comes, and I'm gonna keep progressing and working to the highest level I can while I can.
Let's talk about your opponent here. 18-5 record. What do you know about him? How do you feel like you match up against him here?
I fought Sam before. I think it was three and a half years ago now, maybe coming up to four. You know, he's number one ranked flyweight in Europe for a reason. He's a very good fighter. He was 2-time Cage Warriors champ. Personally, I feel like he should have gone to the UFC, you know, previously in the past, and he's very unfortunate not to. But they're the types of challenges I want when I'm approaching this, and especially when you want to be the champ of Octagon, the biggest organization in Europe, you need to be fighting these legit guys who are tough. So I feel like last time I fought in, it was like only 18 months post chemo.
Oh wow!
So okay. my body was still recovering. I actually for that fight. I ate breakfast and drank a load of water on the morning of the fight, so we didn't know how light I was. So there was a big physical disadvantage my way, and obviously he's very good technically as well, and you can't be giving up, I think, around 10, 12 kilogram against, you know, one of the best fighters in Europe. But I've had 3 years since then, longer, to close the gap, improve technically, physically, mentally, and I'm looking forward to seeing how much I've closed the gap on the weekend.
Training camp, tell me a little bit about that. Who have been some of your main training partners helping you get ready for this fight?
Training camp's gone really well. I'm fortunate to have a lot of great bodies around me. My head coach, Dee Nightingale, has done we've been working together now probably 8-9 years. And got loads of bodies down there. And then I've also been doing bits at Aspire with Phil Turner and Dean Garnett, and managed to get some rounds in with like the likes of Mohamed Mokaev this camp.
Oh, nice.
Which has been really good. You know, I'm fortunate to have a lot of great people around me who've been able to help me, and camp's gone well.
What's that like getting to work with Mokaev from your perspective in terms of, you know, this is a guy that a lot of people feel should be fighting for the flyweight title next. How much confidence does that give you getting to go with him and heading into a big title fight yourself?
Yeah, you know, it's great. He was based out of Aspire when he was in the UK. So when he's back home, he manages to get over there, and I've been fortunate enough to be there on a couple of days he's been there, and we've managed to do some rounds. So it's good for confidence. I've known Mo since he was a young kid, and you know, seeing the likes of him do so well in the UFC, you know, it's motivating, but he also deserves it. I've seen how hard he's worked since a youngster, so it's great to see him progress and develop that way. But I feel like he's a good role model for the UK.
Very well said. You seem like you're in a good mood. I imagine the weight cut's going well. I'm getting you on fight week, so I know sometimes you're in the thick of the weight cut.
Yeah, no, I always try and be in a good mood, to be honest. Like, this is what I choose to do. Obviously, you're hungry, but I don't want to, I try and use these things to give me energy, not take them away. And I am appreciative of the media and how they support us fighters. And I know that this is part and parcel of what's got to be done to help promote the fights and build everyone. So it's almost like a signed deal that, you know, this is part of it now. It's part of the fight game.
Your corner, what will that look like? Who's going to be in the cage with you on Saturday?
So my corner will consist of Steve Nightingale and Jordan Chester, who I also have. And then I'll also be having Phil and Dean from Aspire as well in my corner on the weekend, because you get four with it being a title fight.
How's this fight playing out? How do you see it going down on Saturday?
I see it being a fight that goes in the all areas and aspects, really. I don't see it just being a striking fight. I don't see it just being a grappling fight. Me and Sam are both well-rounded fighters who look to fight in all areas. You know, we're the two flyweights, along with Shaj Haq, who have been in this division the longest and at the top of the division. So we're well-rounded fighters, and I feel like it's going to be a game of small margins and small inches. I always sometimes, like, you know, say when I'm coaching to my guys, it's not always the best fighter who wins, it's the one who makes the best decisions on the night. So I've got to make sure I'm winning those 1% battles, making the best decisions on the night, and coming out with a victory. That's my plan, but I'm not looking for like one route to victory or anything like that, because I don't want to miss anything that I see or not be able to adapt at the right moment. So I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited. I'm inspired by also UFC 300 on the weekend.
I bet. What a fight. I actually just got back from Vegas. I was there live.
Oh, nice.
Covering the event. So it was pretty cool to be on the front lines for that.
Yeah, that was awesome. A historic night. So there's no better fuel and motivation ready for the weekend going into that.
Yeah, I'd say so myself. Any idea who's going to fight the winner of this fight? Have you been told that yet, or do you have an idea of who will? Not looking past Saturday, obviously, you got to get the job
done.
Yeah,
no, I have no idea. And again, like you said there, it would be silly of me to look past that. Obviously, Elias Garcia is now gone, vacated, hiding in a box somewhere, so it won't be him. So, like I said, I'm just focusing on Sam, and then we'll see what's next after that.
Absolutely. It is Octagon 56 coming up here this Saturday. Looking forward to it. Aaron, thanks so much for doing this. Really excited for this one. If there's anyone you want to thank, any sponsors, any social media you want to promote, I'll give you the last word.
No, thanks for having me, James. Just want to thank everyone who supported me on this journey. Saturday could be a monumental part in history, so I appreciate the support, anyone who's been with me since day one, inside and outside of fighting. So I would just like to thank them, thank Octagon for giving me the opportunity, and I'm looking forward to hopefully building on Wrexham's success on the weekend and giving the town another world champion on the weekend.